Are you seeking ways to strengthen your immunity to optimize your overall health and better protect yourself against opportunistic stealth pathogens such as COVID-19? If so, then this week's video blog, Optimizing Immunity with Self-Care Part 1, Top Immune Threats to Avoid, is for you. Hello, I'm Jennifer Ellis Schutz of Empowered Health, which is an online private functional health and transformational coaching practice, as well as Wellness Code Academy, where I offer online courses and training programs for both clients and fellow health and wellness professionals. Be sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the bell to be notified so you don't miss a week's featured video, and to my email list to receive your free action guide, 10 tips for increasing energy and brain function in 10 minutes a day or less. So, when it comes to optimizing immune function, the first most important thing to understand is that stress is the leading cause of poor immune function and chronic disease, and lack of self-care is the leading cause of stress. At one point in my journey with often disabling myalgic encephalomyelitis, also often referred to as chronic fatigue syndrome, I used to get so triggered when anybody or anything suggested that stress played a role in making me sick and was playing a role in keeping me sick, and that my self-care needed much improvement. I felt the level of severity of the health issues I experienced, despite huge efforts to get well, was undermined by this notion. I felt invalidated. It was crazy-making for me. Now that I understand the true meaning of both stress and self-care, however, I now see much truth in this. You see, stress comes in all shapes and sizes. Stress includes physical, mental, emotional, environmental, physiological, and biochemical insults to our body, mind, and spirit. And we all have a stress threshold. When this threshold is exceeded for too long, the body, mind, and spirit get derailed, making us not only more vulnerable to opportunistic invaders such as COVID-19, but also to the development of chronic disease. My life journey has taught me that self-care is our best weapon against the many stressors that impair our immunity, and if and when we do succumb to illness, it is our most powerful healer. One's level and quality of self-care absolutely heavily influence one's level of resilience against acute insults, as well as whether or not they will develop chronic illness, and if they do develop chronic illness, their ability to recover from it. By self-care, I'm not referring to treating oneself to a day at a wellness spa or a golf outing, although these things can absolutely be part of one's overall approach. By self-care, I'm referring to everything about how we show up in the world in our daily lives. This includes our nutrition, sleep, movement, mindset, self-talk, daily patterns, relationships, the information we choose to consume and pay attention to, and the list goes on. This said, in order to arm you with practical strategies to begin working on in your own life to strengthen your immunity and increase your resilience through self-care strategies, here is a list of the top immune threats to be aware of and begin eliminating if you have not already done so. First up is processed sugar and everything containing it, such as soft drinks, candy, cookies, pastries, processed foods, and more. It's important to know that in order to metabolize just one single molecule of sugar, the body requires at least 56 molecules of magnesium, dozens of molecules of vitamins, enzymes, minerals, and nutrients, all of which we need for a robust immune system. So when we consume processed sugar, we deplete our bodies of these nutrients, leaving us vulnerable to disease. The only sugar, in my opinion, suitable for consumption is that found naturally in fruit and raw unprocessed honey, because the sugar in both of these is bound to all the nutrients I just listed out. Next, we have processed carbohydrates such as cakes, biscuits, chips, crackers, breakfast cereals, bread, pasta, and more. After this comes chemically altered and artificial fat such as margarine, vegetable oils, butter replacements, and processed foods with these ingredients in them. Next, we have lack of high-quality protein and fat in the diet from organic, pasture-raised, and grass-fed meats, fish, eggs, raw dairy if you can get your hands on it, nuts, and seeds. Then we have chronic psychological stress. Research in the field of psychoneuroimmunology, yes, this is a real-world area of study, which is the study of how mental and emotional states impact the body's physiology, has confirmed that repressed painful emotions and habitual stress thought patterns activate a chronic stress response. This protection mechanism, commonly known as fight or flight, is for short-term emergency use only. Chronic activation of the stress response is directly and measurably linked to a weak immune response, inflammation, musculoskeletal tension, anxiety, depression, impaired higher cognitive function, and ultimately symptoms, illness, and disease. Then comes not having a daily recharge ritual. When it comes to self-care and optimal health, I've come to learn that the most resilient, healthiest, happiest, and most fulfilled people in the world are those who make recharging their physical, mental, and emotional reserves a priority to some degree each day. The top reason this is so critical is that we are in a bi-directional relationship with the universe around us. In other words, we receive from the universe what we contribute to it. So, if we want abundance and vitality in our life, then we must offer the universe abundance and vitality. And in order to do this, we must first build up our own bank account of abundance and vitality capital versus running on a deficit. After this, which goes along with having a daily recharge ritual, is burning the midnight oil, pushing beyond one's capacity and not listening to the whispers of discomfort that the body sends until they turn into loud screams. Up next is exposure to man-made chemicals found within non-toxic household products, personal care products, and makeup. Then comes excessive exposure to man-made radiation coming from computers, cell phones, Wi-Fi, tablets, and other tech gadgets that we've all come to love and depend on. After this comes long-term and excessive use of prescription drugs such as antibiotics, steroids, acid reducers, painkillers, antidepressants, and more. While there is definitely a time and place for appropriate use of prescription drugs in some scenarios, especially with acute issues, I've come to learn that poor health is not caused by a lack of them, and taking them long term most often merely masks symptoms and drives dysfunction deeper into the body. Up next, we have lack of fresh air and sunlight, connection with nature, and movement. And lastly, lack of exposure to beneficial environmental microbes due to overuse of toxic sterilization products used for personal care, household cleaning, and toxic sanitizing agents in the water supply, such as fluoride and chlorine. Please know, however, that this is not to be taken as discouragement from absolute vigilance in terms of practicing hand washing, wearing face masks, and more in the face of pandemic pathogenic invaders such as COVID-19. Currently, it is important that we all continue taking these necessary precautions while also keeping our sights on the big picture of optimizing immune health so that we build up resilience against acute insults and not become a statistic. In closing, I'm confident that if you take to heart what I presented in this video and begin taking steps each day to reduce or eliminate these immune threats from your life, that you will significantly increase your resilience. And that's a wrap for this week's video. Stay tuned for the next video in this immunity series, where I will discuss three specific, simple, yet hugely powerful self-care strategies for supercharging your resilience and making yourself bulletproof against invading pathogens. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in personalized coaching services, you can connect with me at www.empoweredheal.com. And if you're a health professional seeking to improve client outcomes and up-level your coaching skills and your business, be sure to check out my flagship certification program, The Wellness Code, at www.empoweredtoheal.com/wellness code. Until next time, all my best to you.